and the Media Whiz, because one art form wasn't enough. And I'm joined by
Nostalgia Kid
and
Duke CT, does random videos and such. So yes.
And today we're gonna. This is an unscripted rant because I have lots to complain about with this. This is a rant on TLC. At one point, it was called the Learning Channel, but the television that they, the shows that they air on their channel nowadays are so brain dead. It makes you wonder why they keep the initials TLC.
Mm-hmm. Cupcake Cam, that's nice. Okay, Love, Lust, or Run. You know, let's see what else. For Swipe, it's great. One on the Medium, Say Yes to the Dress.
That I'm gonna rant about.
Rattled, and so on. And you know, as me, as a person who, I understand some of these shows. I mean, for example, the 600 pound stuff, fine. It's a nice little motivation for people who, you know, lose weight and all that type of stuff. That's fine.
Yeah. But
everything else here is completely, you know, the fiddle. Like, for example, say, The Little Couple.
Oh, yeah. Well, I feel like, okay, so I might as well tell you guys how I started watching TLC, and you guys can join in on this. When I started watching TLC, it's back around, like, 2011 when they started airing Toddlers and Tiaras, which just, it felt like just hey, let's show off these soccer moms who like to, you know, use their kids as accessories and put them in, like, these beauty pageants for little kids, which just, it felt really just, like,
pandering. Which is basically, like, abuse to your kid.
Well, you know, they seemed like, hey, the whole Germanasia thing, yeah, that wasn't really anything.
Yeah. But then, if there's anything that this show did give us, it eventually gave us the spinoff to what was probably the worst show I've watched in a long time before they inevitably got canceled. That being Here Comes Honey Boo Boo.
Oh, yes, Honey Boo Boo, that thing. Again, this is one of the reasons why I don't watch reality shows or anything like the negative outlook I have on them is because
yes.
Shows like that that just have nothing very positive or anything really interesting to say. It's just people, well, playing up their characters 24/7 and
yeah.
Such, which, you know.
Like the Kardashians always play up, you know, being obnoxious glamour supermodels. Honey Boo Boo and family play up being obnoxious, overweight rednecks.
Yeah, I can see why some people might not like that fact.
Yeah.
But I do see the appeal of those things.
The same thing with Duck Dynasty. I mean, like, it has an audience. We're just not it.
Yeah.
It's cheap. That's the reason why these things...
And it's lazy, too. I mean, you just put camera... It's pretty much televised home movies.
Yeah, for the most part, that's why the network is full of it.
Because it's cheap to make.
It's cheap. Cheaper than actually pro wrestling, believe it. Pro wrestling, with all the hoopla and the hollow and such, very cheap to produce. And such.
Yeah.
But with this, it's, you know, very cheap and such. Anyway,
so.
It's again the horrible thing out there, but you know, it's one of the reasons why I just stopped watching any type of reality shows whatsoever. You know, WWE with their whole diva stuff. I only watched one episode of that and I just got tired of it. I don't care how many people say it's great. It's just, again, it's the same tropes over and over and over again.
Yeah. And then, like, eventually Honey Boo Boo got canceled because, as it turned out, the dad was actually a pedophile, which I'll bring that up. It comes into play with another show I wanted to talk about. So Honey Boo Boo eventually ended, and I was like, wow, you know, the worst show on TV is finally over. Then I, like, looked at all the other TLC programming. Like, one day I was just skimming it, and it turns out all their other shows are no better. Like, like you just listed off a couple. Like, they have, like, cooking shows like Cupcake Cam and Say Yes to the Dress. Then you got shows like Little People, which are just there to appeal to, like, a bunch of other, like, demographics. Like, Little People's for, like, people who are short, which there's nothing wrong with trying to appeal to a demographic. But, like, it feels pandering, especially considering there's, like, three shows about, you know, short people, and it just feels like they're trying way too hard. There's a show about a girl who's, like, 7 feet tall, so it's, like, and apparently, like, the world sees her as a freak, but it's just, like, is a girl being 7 feet tall really...
This is the epitaph of first world problems.
Exactly.
And, you know, to me, when I see, again, the reality shows, and I don't understand what the Learning Channel was trying to do, to rebrand, because... Same thing with history, and
yeah.
Because a lot of people seem to forget that, you know, there used to be these shows that they had. There used to be this, that, and the other, but The reason why they go on this different path is because, well, this is a lot more lucrative, this makes more money, fine. But at least for history, there's still a type of connecting towards it. Regardless of the guy with the, say, aliens, it's like, say, still history, you know, around it. Pseudo-history, but still history.
Yeah, then you got, let's see, other shows that they're trying way too hard to appeal to. Mm. Amish people, like, they have, like, shows like Amish Mafia, which I'm pretty sure that's over. Then, one that I loved, one that they, what was it?
My Big Gypsy Wedding was one.
Oh, yeah, they're trying way too hard to appeal to gypsies with that show. One show, though, one thing they're really trying to connect to is Mormons. Now, look, there's nothing wrong with religion whatsoever. In fact, there's even a show about a woman who goes around to, like, natural disaster places and preaches Christianity, which, again, nothing wrong with it. It has its demographic, but it feels, again, it's cheap and lazy. But the worst offender is another show that got canceled, once again, to pedophilia, was 19 Kids and Counting.
And, well, the Duggars.
The Duggars, exactly.
I was just about to say that.
This show, honestly, is the second. This is probably this and Honey Boo Boo are neck and neck for worst reality TV show. I mean, reality TV, I don't like, period, but this is awful.
It is. I saw one piece of it, one of the specials, and I was like, I don't want to judge people who do, because, people around my clan love to watch shows like this, and I'm like, fine, if it's entertaining to you, that's great.
Yeah.
But I was like, how is this thing, people watch this stuff? Same thing with Duck Dynasty.
Yes.
But then again, I look at that, I'm like, okay, at least they're producing something.
Yeah.
And there are some reality shows that there are some interest, like, for example, Tank on Animal Planet.
Of course.
Really interesting show. My brother loves it because, you know, loves, like, people building all these, like, specialized fish stuff.
Shark Tank is another one. And, yeah. like, all the Gordon Ramsay shows are great.
Yeah, there are some good stuff in that.
There's Diamonds in the Rough.
Yeah.
But, oh my, like, okay, I saw one episode, and it had the eldest daughter, I think her name's Jess.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, and she was going on a date with a guy, and she tells her parents that she's going on this date, and they're like, well, cool, we'll have a double date. And it was so creepy.
I saw that.
And the entire time, it was just creepy because it just felt like...
Did you see the dad's goober face looking like...
Serious.
It's so creepy. It's like you're going on a junior prom with someone and your parents go to chaperone and the entire time they're just hanging around you and it feels really awkward. And of course, like, I mean, there's like tons of stuff. Like, I mean, one time they interviewed Jess and Jess said this thing about like atheism is the reason we had World War and stuff like that. And
never studied. This is a Christian here.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I've, you know, me, my dad, all this stuff, study, you know, the war reasons why war. One, twos, and all this type of stuff has happened.
Exactly.
And believe you me, atheism had little to nothing to do with most of that stuff.
True.
You know.
And then, of course, the show ended because it turned out, once again, just like Honey Boo Boo involved pedophilia, it turned out that Josh, their eldest kid, who was like 20, I remember him being born in like the 80s when I looked it up. Apparently, it turned out he's a pedophile, and he tried doing it with one of the siblings, which is really just disturbing.
That's both pedophilia and incest.
Right? Yeah. And so it was just downright disgusting. And so it isn't like, it feels really coincidental, the fact that two shows on TLC, which are like their most popular and their most intolerable, ended in pedophilia. It feels like coincidental.
It feels disgusting.
It is a, well, again, this is the bed they made, the reality show. Well, I mean, they could go back to something like maybe do a rebranding of it because they're something which I think hopefully they do. Because,
they'll get someone else.
You know, not just the reality show and stuff, but also go back to, say, the Learning Channel. Go back to where, you know, what made their bread and butter. You know, doctor stuff, maybe. Because, right now, I mean, Learning Channel. I mean, you have, like, say, cell phones, you can do stuff about shuttles, internet, that sort of thing.
Like, the most interesting thing that they had on TLC recently was they had a documentary about Disneyland, and easily that was, like, the most entertaining thing because it was entertaining and it was informative.
Which some of they used to do.
Yeah.
Sadly,
they had Magic School Bus at one point.
No, I shudder to think what they... That's why the Magic School Bus, they hop-shipped to Netflix. They're like, shoot.
Yeah.
I think some of the episodes of Magic School Bus are on that channel, Cubo.
Yeah. But to wrap things up, easily, TLC has... I mean, again, I know what they're trying to do, like Duke said, but me personally, I think TLC offers some of the most least entertaining shows. I mean, at least for me. Like, there's a handful of ones that are good. Like you said, like my 6,000 pound life, it shows people trying to lose weight, you know, the struggles they go through. That's good. Like, it's trying to reach out to people. But every other thing, it feels like they're just pandering to try it. They're trying way too hard to appeal to people. And that's just no way to make entertainment. Like, you make entertainment that you think would be entertaining, and then you find a target fan base. With this, it's just, hey.
It's the same show over and over and over again.
With different people.
Like, yeah. Like, for example, like, I get what you mean by, like, it's the same show, but, like, for example, like, 19 Kids Count is basically, like, a cross between 16 and Pregnant and Teen Mom.
Exactly, yeah. That's exactly what it is. So, yeah, out of all the Honey Boo Boo was awful, 19 Kids and Counting was awful, there's a bunch of other awful shows in between. Handful of, it's just like reaction channels. There's a handful of them you like, the rest is...
But we can't say that. No,
fine. The Fine Bros, shut your mouth! Fine Bros, yeah, that's, I don't know if I'll ever do a rant on that, I mean, I think
it's been destroyed anyway.
Yeah, everyone said their piece on it.
Alpha Magazine.
Yeah.
Shot them.
Yeah.
Subpoena will be in the mail.
Seth Rogen will give it to us.
You've been served.
But yeah, overall, TLC, we don't really like it. It's not for us, but if you like it, good for you. But for us personally, we can't stomach it.
The reality shows in general, I just can't. You know, there's sometimes you just look at it and you're like, man, you can only watch it for so long.
Yep. So... thank you for watching this rant. I'm the Media Wiz, because Warrant Form wasn't enough, and I was joined by...
The Nostalgia Kid.
And...
Dixie T.
Channel Zero, people.
Shark Wayne.
Patrick Alexander.
With the Baylor Club t-shirt, which, you know.
Lala, who does Let's Plays over there in the corner.
Where we usually keep her.
Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you again. Bye.
A scrub is a guy that thinks he's fine and is also known as a buster. Always checking out what he wants and just sits on his broke ass.